So my topic is about data visualization, training, not just super heroes. Does anyone love superheroes? Even people older, we love superheroes. So, yeah. Data visualization, adding not just superheroes.
Technical person.
So, I said not just superheroes. Then who else it could be? Those else could be our real life superheroes, like our defense organizations, ATO agencies, government officials, and such kind of different organizations that works from human safety, security perspective. They help us to make so they help us in resolving the issues that we face from a natural disaster or from a man-made disaster. That's what our real life superheroes do. We can call them a superhero, though they don't have a superpower, but still we can call them superheroes. But how come data visualization will help them? Basically, data visualization is a technique, is a method through which we can understand data and we can play with the data. There are multiple ways of data visualization. The way different users interact with the data, they can derive their own insight out of it. So that's why we say data visualization is for big data and it covers a broader spectrum of the data. So here we say how data visualization will help us superheroes is because it gives you a unique way to communicate with the data. Right? And through that data, different user identify patterns, different trends or correlations. So some of their objective might to identify a trend, so they will go with those kind of visualizations. If somebody wants to identify some kind of patterns, they will go with those kind of visualizations. So there are multiple things to it, but we'll just only cover the part which is relevant to our talk. So people who utilize data visualization, 20% feel that they can easily find the information like the people who use normal dashboards or reporting tools, they find very delay in terms of insight they want to infer or the information they are seeking for. But people who use data visualization, they can quickly find the relevant information and take their further actions accordingly. Similarly, 48% of people say, people who use data visualization, they are saying without any technical support, they can find their relevant information or data. So just to connect with the data visualization with our superhero, how data visualization helps them. So we saw the definition and other things, but now if you have seen like how the Tony Stark is juggling and playing with the visualization on air, and he tweaks it, he manipulates it, and whatever information you want to infer from it, he takes. So the next step is taken based on whatever information or insight that he derived from the particular piece of data. So that's how, so all this kind of a data visualization where you see the different information. Similarly, the hood that he has, it got many other multiple devices. The devices that help him to identify location or the context, the goal, and the sensor display of the information. From that, the insight that he infers is he can easily understand what is the charging percentage of his suit that is wearing so that he can find an alternate source of charges in terms of some task that is performing. He can also identify where the target object is, what is the position, what is the distance of an object, weight analysis, and all those kind of. There are multiple insights to it, but these are just few of them which I have highlighted. From the insight, what is the action does he take? He can instantly take any decision with the help of this data and with the help of this insight, so that any unexpected problem that has arisen, he can take a quick decision. That's why data visualization is meant for. So that user, whoever uses the data visualization, they can take an immediate action and proceed further. Similarly, identify target and shoot remotely, instant analyzing problems. All these are actions that you perform after analyzing the data. Similarly, in various fields like our healthcare, transport, business, politics, social life, data visualization, analyzing data visualization or understanding data visualization is a big challenge. So how do we come to resolve that problem? So since we all are UX people, we are designers, we think from a design perspective, so how our design can make a daily impact with the help of data visualization to make our city smarter, to make our city better place to live. So as in yesterday's commissioner said that the traffic issues needs to be resolved. So such kind of issues can also be resolved with the help of data visualization if we go with the proper process and channel. So now we will come to the case study or a concept where which is related to our real life superheroes, not with the real life superheroes. So participatory surveillance and participatory sensing, these are the two patents that TCS has published. There are many patents that TCS has published, but it's relevant to our super admin or our city administrator who has to manage or optimize or plan our city better. These two are the relevant patents that we have identified, and we integrated these two storylines together and created a concept that would really help our city administrator to plan things better. So these are the references in case you want to go through the what exactly this patent are about, so you can go into the detail of it. So when we went to the patent, so what that patent addresses, these are the challenges that what it addresses. Like, there is no system to assist government and defense organizations. There are systems, but then they are not so effective, which will really help them to quickly solve their problem. Because so this is mainly related to the disaster, or either a natural human disaster or man-made disaster. But people, our city administrator cannot easily identify these things when the system is not available. So it takes time for him to take further action. So there is a delay in it. So delay in this case is very, very crucial. And if there is a delay, then there is a big loss for us. There is a natural loss for us, there is a property loss for us, there is a casualty loss for us, a human loss. Then the participatory surveillance that the current system has, it gives a lot of frequent false alarms. So the system itself was not so built enough, capable enough to give you a real kind of data. So a lot of analytics and improvement was needed from the system side. So that's how the current system is. So it used to give false alarm, which really triggered an unnecessary operation for the administrator to take, and again have to bear an unnecessary cost. So again, it goes to the government part that they have to bear an unnecessary cost and because of this false alarm. Then analyzing data becomes tedious for them, because there is a manual intervention over here where they have to go through all the data and analyze things, and again there is a delay in taking further actions or decisions, which we have to avoid. Then unavailability of crucial information. So event or incident or disaster, this can happen at any, you cannot predefine like where it is going to happen. So the surveillance camera that are planted in the city, that are placed in the city, not necessarily that it will happen in that area itself, it can happen. It's an arbitrary situation. The sites can be arbitrary. So you might not get a crucial or relative information because of that. So after all these challenges and understanding these two patents, we came up with a concept where these two where you see the first two parts, the CCTV camera and the mobile is a part of participatory surveillance. And the second part, sensor monitoring system, is part of our second patent, that is participatory sensing. So that is that. So multiple sources, and the middle layer is the analytical engine, and this is the admin dashboard. So I will quickly explain you. The information from the multiple resources goes to the respective analytical engine, and it gives you the filtered, the mined, the refined data to the administrator so that he can perform his task easily. Now we will go with the design solution, the what solution, how the admin goes, can he sees the dashboards, when he, on the dashboard, how, what are the further actions that he needs to perform. So all the things we will display, we will see over here. So this is the dashboard where users get to see the real time and the trend view of both the type of disaster, natural disaster or man-made disaster. The alerts and notifications are being displayed over here. For a timing, he clicks on man-made disaster. He sees an alert over there, he goes to man-made disaster. We take a geographical view, because geography representing all this information in a form of tabular or some kind of sheet would be very difficult for him to scan through and identify what where are the alerted areas, what is the problem is. It will take a lot of time. So giving a geographical view where the incidents have happened, it shows in a form of heat map. When he clicks with the largest impacted area, you get to see the tweets, Facebook feeds and apps, which is part of that participatory surveillance app. You get to see information related to those incidents. Here, the three incidents that user has selected is of terror attack, blast and fire. So the color represent all these three different incidents. This is the area where user has zoomed in when he clicked on that heat map here, where he zoomed in, and you get to see the number of photos, the number of videos and audios uploaded by the citizen since it is a participatory surveillance, that means the citizen of the country or location, they have to participate. They install the app, they contribute wherever they see incident, they click photos, they upload it, they record the videos, they upload it. So all those videos, photos, audio, everything goes to that analytical engine, and that comes in a dashboard. And this is what the screen is, where you get to see the photos, videos and audios of this whatever citizen has uploaded. Here we have a nearby service area where once he analyzes all this data and he clicks on the nearby service area, so you get all those detail, emergency details related to that location. So now user has clicked on Twitter. If you want to go for a further detailed analysis, you go through each tweet and identify what is the problem is and what other next step he has to take. Then he clicks on photos. You get to see the photos which are refined and filtered, not all the photos that citizen. After the analytic engine has refined the data, those data are being displayed over here, not the all data that citizen has uploaded. Then similarly, we can see the audio. When you click on the audio, you get to see the audio. The user can hear the audio, what it is talking about, what the incidents, what is the background, how the background noise is. He can analyze that based on which location, what exactly they are seeing. It's a terror attack or something, what is the next plan? So all these things you can analyze by listening to the videos if needed. Then that was the citizen contribution. Now if you want to see the sensory contribution, which is the second patent, the same thing gets converted into a heat map. Now it gives you another kind of information. It's talked about the temperature of that particular location where the blast and fire has been occurred. And also at the same time, it also gives you the direction in which direction the fire is going. So that according to this information, the administrator will take the next step or action. If you want to see a live CCTV footage, he clicks on that option and you get to see live CCTV footage over here. That live thing he can get to see only in the sensor citizen, not in the citizen contribution. When you click on the nearby area, you get to see those emergency details which I was talking about earlier, ambulance, fire brigade and police station. Then he goes to the trend view. Now whatever we saw, these were the real-time data. Now if you want to plan for the future, you want to take some actions, you want to improvise the city, you want to plan better for a city, so for that you need to understand what is the trend of this data. So if you see here, we have two axes. In both the axes we have numerical data. One is both are talking about the timeline. This is talking about the years, and the horizontal part is talking about the timeline for how long the event or incident has been occurred. So for all these incidents, you will always find a temper at the end. Why? Because at the end, the incident will definitely get resolved. Our rescue team are there for that. Our city administration are there for that. So whichever data comes over here, you will find a temper at that. But the distance is telling for how long that incident occurred and for when it got mitigated. So if you see in 2011, there were a lot of incidents that happened. But as you keep progressing, you can see that there are less incidents happening. Why is that? We'll come to know. So when you click on one of this ribbon kind of visualization, it has a metaphor to it. It's not that it's just for a visual representation, but this ribbon has some meaning to it. We'll get to know. When you click on this ribbon, it gives you the detail of the incident. Like the bulge area will tell how many casualties, how many injuries, how many property loss and natural loss happened in that particular period of time. And the slightly thinner area will tell during that period some kind of rescue has happened or some kind of problem has been resolved. But again, if you see a bulge again over there, and you see some more problem has arisen. But that's how, so always it won't be a kind of a ribbon, kind of a this wave shape or fire shape, but it would be definitely a ribbon kind of visualization. But again, it's in the metaphor of fire. Yeah. So again, it's in a metaphor of fire which gives you a feel of that blast, incidents, or terror has, event has occurred. So that's why it's been given in a fire manner. So in 2011, if you see the contribution from this app or the patent that I was talking about, it was less. So that's why you see the incidents are still high over there. But as you keep progressing, if you keep click on 2015, you see the contribution is more. So the incident has occurred, so those are less. So this is the desired outcome of this visualization, out of this design solution that we provided. It helps to reduce the false alarm because the analytical engine, the technology and the design both helps them to understand that this is a false alarm. Whenever there is a real alarm, it will give them an indication that only those part will come on their dashboard. So that's how it reduces the false alarm. It reduces the effect of disaster. It gives you both a real-time event trend view, and you can quickly connect to the nearby area. You can initiate the investigation. These all are the outcome of this visualization or the design concept that we have given for our city administration. So that's it. So let's be all be a superhero. We are designers. We can utilize our design power and create such kind of solution that would really help to our society, and we can create a good social impact from our design power. Thank you. Hope be superhero.
Picture can validate incident is a video. We can how we can validate the voice. Is it real or?
So that's what the analytical engine does, which is the middle layer of it. I said there was multiple sources which feeds this data into the analytical engine, and based on some algorithm, that analytical engine has, it runs, it sees that what are the relevant information, it validates amongst all those different scenarios or all the different resources that it has. It will check through video feed, it will check through photos, it will validate through your audio sound that we saw. So there are multiple resources. It will validate through all those things based on some algorithm, and it will display only the relevant information on the dashboard and not all of them. That's how it will work. So that's why I said if the technology and what design will go hand in hand, and then we can create it again.
One more question.
How did you solve the direction of fire in terms of visualization?
So there are two patents to it. One is Participatory Surveillance, which is an app, and second one which talks about, it tells about the direction of the fire and the temperature of the fire. Those are the sensory devices placed within the city and within the locality, which gives you those readings and data.
And I like it. Thank you.
Yeah, so I would request Shyam to give away the token of appreciation to Balakrishna. I would also request Ranjit to come up on the stage.